All right.
All right, we got some great questions today. Pat, is it true that you must be baptized in Jesus' name in order for Jesus to accept you? Is it true that if you were baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that your baptism is invalid? Do you even have to be baptized in order to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
There's a group known as Jesus Only, and they're very dedicated people. They're called Oneness. And they believe in it's all in the name of Jesus. Everything's in the name of Jesus. When I baptize people, I just cover all bases. I say, I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Then I've got them all. But I don't think we go for little formulas. God is a spirit. They that worship in spirit and in truth, not little formulas, like I've said the right three words and therefore I'm accepted by God. Yeah. No way. So don't worry about stuff like that. It's not necessary. What you want to do is your heart. You worship in your heart, okay?
Amen. Patricia writes in, is it true that it is not God's will for anyone to remain sick? Our daughter has suffered with chronic migraine headaches for over 13 years. She is disabled and cannot work, and now her husband left her. She has not only done every medical treatment known to man, she has been to healing rooms for hundreds of prayers, prayed over her, etc., but to no avail.
I don't know what to say. There's some who say it's not God's will that any. Here's the way. When Jesus was here on earth, he was the representative of God Almighty. There is not one instance that we have in the Bible where he ever turned anyone down. He made them wait a little bit to test their faith, but never did he refuse to heal anybody. They all were healed, everybody. But the difference about Jesus and us is that he knew exactly what was wrong with people. He knew when something was demonic. He knew when something was disease. He knew when something was lack of faith. He knew all that. He knew when something was sin. And he could deal with people. We don't have that discerning of people's spirits the way he did, nor do we have a walk with God that Jesus did. But if we were like Jesus, everybody would get healed that we deal with. Mm. Okay.
All right, Juanita writes, could you explain 1 Thessalonians 4:17? Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord.
Well, he's talking about the rapture. The Thessalonians are saying, well, the second coming, how's it going to work? And the dead going to go first, or they're not going to go first, and are we going to go first? And he said, well, those of us who are alive are not going to go ahead of the dead people. And then the dead are going to rise, and then we who remain are going to be transformed. We will be transformed into spiritual beings, and we will ascend to be with the Lord, and we will therefore ever be with the Lord. That's what he's talking about. He's talking about the second coming of Jesus. And this is what's called the catching away or the rapture. The word rapture comes from a Latin rapio, I snatch. And we're talking about the catching up of God's people. Those of us who are alive will be caught up, will be transformed instantly in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, bang, and we're up with Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah, that's where we're all going one of these days. Wendy.
Amen.